Today we will take a look at the procedure for an APU fire. The APU is running, and we are cruising at 31,000 feet. The APU is a gas turbine engine, located within a fireproof compartment in the tail of the aircraft. It is regularly used on the ground to power the aircraft when ground power is not available, or prior to push to facilitate power after disconnecting from ground power, and to supply bleed air for engine start. It can provide both electrical power and bleed air up to 10,000 feet, bleed air only, up to 17,000 feet, or electrical power only, up to 41,000 feet. Three detectors alert of an APU fire at 232 degrees Celsius, or 450 degrees Fahrenheit. There is also a single loop detector. APU fire protection is provided by one fire extinguishing bottle. When a fire is detected, the fire warning light and master caution lights illuminate. APU is also illuminated on the annunciator panel, and a fire warning bell also sounds. The APU fire handle is also illuminated. The first action is to clarify who is flying, by the pilot flying stating, "My aircraft." Once the crew have identified the issue, the master caution can be pressed to stop the fire warning bell. The first two steps of the checklist are memory items, and are performed without delay, before calling for the checklist. After the pilot flying calls for the APU fire checklist, the pilot monitoring checks for it on the quick reference card if applicable, then goes to the quick reference handbook, known as the QRH. Starting at the quick action index, the APU fire title is shown in capital letters, and refers us to page 8.1. The pilot monitoring then states the title of the checklist they are looking at, followed by the condition, in this case, that fire is detected in the APU. If the pilot flying agrees that it is the correct checklist, the pilot monitoring proceeds to run the checklist. The first step calls for the APU fire switch to be pulled, rotated to the stop, and held for 1 second, but the confirm indicates the other pilot must agree it is the APU fire switch that's about to be pulled, before doing so. The action of pulling the APU fire switch up closes the APU fuel and bleed air shutoff valves, causing the APU to shut down. It also arms the APU fire bottle discharge squib and closes the air inlet door. Rotating the fire switch either to the left or right discharges halon into the APU. It should be held in the rotated position until the APU bottle discharge light illuminates. Step 2 now directs for the APU switch to be moved to the off position. Step 3 is conditional: is the APU fire switch extinguished or not? Looking at the APU fire switch, we can see it is no longer illuminated, the fire is out. The four black boxes indicate under this option would indicate the APU fire checklist has been completed. Had the fire switch still been illuminated, the checklist directs us to step 4, which is to land at the nearest suitable airport. This is not surprising since the only APU fire bottle has been used, and the fire is still detected. The four black boxes under step 4 indicate in this scenario that the switch is still illuminated, the checklist has now been completed. Please subscribe and join us next time to learn more about the 737. Thank you.